Hi everybody, welcome to part 16. This is going to be a pretty quick one. It's kind of building on some of the other things that we've done in the past. I think it was part 7. Yeah, part 7 we did live face detection with live video. I'm using pretty much the same program. There I had one classifier that was just for human face, front facing human face. Here I have two classifiers that are for cats. So, and I set them to two different colors. One is set to blue, one is set to green. So the other one had one classifier and then it had one of these blocks. So I have faces for one classifier and faces two for the second classifier. And then I have two for loops, one for loop for in faces, which is the first classifier, and a for loop for faces two, which is the second classifier. And I just set the colors different. So these are backwards. So it's a red, green, blue going from here to here to here. So this would be green and this would be blue in these cases, and they're both the same width. So they're going to draw, each classifier has its own colored box. One's going to be blue, one's going to be green. So if it's detected in with both classifiers, you'll see both of the bounding boxes drawn around them. So it's a little complicated when it gets down to this part. So I have it so that when it detects a cat coming towards your keyboard, some of my students have had issues with cats walking across their keyboards in class and typing a bunch of gibberish onto the screen or in Slack or wherever. So this is like the first shot. We're going to probably do multiple iterations in a couple different versions of things like this. This is my first rough draft on the cat detector 2.0. 1.0 was even worse because 1.0 I didn't use threading. So what would happen was when it would set off the bark alarm, which is what's going to scare the cat away, the entire program would freeze. The video feed would freeze. The printout of what the count for the bark alarm was at would freeze. Then everything would freeze. So I had to import the threading module from threading, import thread. And I had to make a separate thread for the audio to play while the main program was still running. So it basically splits off and those two different things run in parallel with each other. Otherwise it locks up the whole program as soon as the bark alarm goes off and the audio starts. So let's run this quick and see what it looks like. So down here is my running count of my bark alarm, and I have it set so that when it gets to the bark alarm, this means the bark alarm divided by 23, this percent sign, it's the modulus or modulo, and it'll give you the remainder. So bark alarm divided by 23, if the remainder equals zero, then it's gonna bark. And I can change this number. So if I made this two, whenever the bark alarm was divisible by two, there'd be a zero remainder. So at 2, 4, 6, 8, at every one of those counts down here, you can't tell now because it's not receiving any images, but you'll see that this count will start going up. So if I wanted this audio to play every single time this count was a even number, I could put that two there, but now it's only going to play when the count gets to 23, 46, 69, and so on and so forth. It has to be divisible by 23, evenly divisible by 23, so that the remainder is zero. And also, when I first set it up, if I didn't have this bark alarm is not equal to zero, when it would start out, the remainder would be zero because you're dividing zero by 23. So anyway, it has to be above zero and it has to be divisible by 23. Any more than that and it takes too long after it sees the cat before it starts barking, and any less than that and it's constantly playing it and it's playing multiple versions of itself overlapping with itself. So we'll see how this works here. So assume you're sitting here, I have the second camera, you see the slower frame rate because using open CV. So I got a couple. Now if you look down at the bottom in the interpreter here, you'll see it's at two. So it got some false positives when I was moving my hand around. I don't see it doing it now, but it got a couple false positives. So it counted up to two. And assume you're just sitting here and all of a sudden your cat decides he wants to come up. Oh, it found. So you see there's a green and a blue bounding box. Those are the two different classifiers. And if I go up here to, or down here, I should say. So this is the green and this is the blue. So the top one is green, so that's this classifier, and the second one is blue. So sometimes you'll see just one or just the other because they were trained on separate data sets, so they detect slightly differently. So sometimes you'll see a green, sometimes you'll see a blue. Most of the time you'll see both at the same time if the cat's facing full on front. And you see the counts down at the bottom, down here. So anytime that count hits something that's divisible by 23, it'll go down here and it will open another thread and it'll call that barking, target equals barking, as the barking function up here. Define barking, play sound dot play sound bark wave. So it's a wave audio file that's being played whenever this bark alarm is triggered. And that's off of this number down here because I have it printing. I think we're at here. When it's too frequent. So I have it print out the current bark alarm every time as it goes down through here. For whatever reason, I can't see where it's at now, but yeah, I don't see it. But that's what you're seeing down here is the printout of the current value of the bark alarm variable. So I mean, it detects it pretty well. It'd be pretty hard for a cat to see. It's also trained so well. I was bragging about it, now it's not working that well. There it goes. It depends on the angle that you hold the book. Even this comic book is painting of cats. It detects the faces of the cats. So that's... But anyway, right now I just have it doing audio. We had a whole bunch of different ideas for things that we could do to get it to shoo the cat away. And also... it'd be nice to incorporate locking out the keyboard using a function that locks the keyboard out, or cuts, if you're in Zoom, maybe turns your camera off or mutes you, or depending on what the situation is. If it's gonna be a situation where you gotta get up and get the cat, maybe have it automatically stop your audio and video for your Zoom meeting, which can be done with shortcut keys. I'm sure there's a module in Python where you can just, instead of playing that audio, have it execute this module that actuates those shortcut keys while you're in Zoom. So this is just like the very first simple building block. I'm sure we'll talk about.